Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 18 Beta 3 re-release. The re-release typically comes out before the public beta. They do this every single year, and so it sort of refines it, gets it ready, and then brings the build numbers up to the same that we expect with the public beta. We'll talk about when to expect that a little bit later, but first, this came in at only 360.7 megabytes. That's on my 15 Pro Max, and it was about the same size on other devices here. Apple also released just a couple other updates, iPadOS 18 Beta 3 re-release and macOS 15 Sequoia Beta 3 re-release. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. And as you can see, the build number is 22A5307i. Again, this is a change from the build number from Beta 3 and typically brings it up to date to sort of sync that up to what we have with iOS 18 Public Beta 1 when that's released. Now, as far as a modem update, we don't have a new modem update coming from Beta 3 to the Beta 3 re-release, but we do have a couple changes to talk about. The first thing has to do with one of the major changes we had with Beta 3 with the emoji picker. If we go into our emojis here, you'll see that they've reverted this back to what we had before. So the actual keyboard before had some stickers down here, that's no longer here, and the Memoji option is not there either. So they've changed this back, we have some haptic feedback like before, but they've changed it back and it's not the same as we had with the Beta 3 release. So they've brought this to five different lines or rows of what we have with different emoji, but no stickers here. We also can't put stickers in a row anymore. So if we go to our stickers and then we try to place them in a row, they don't work. They just swap out. So you can't do what we have just above it where we had that with Beta 3. So just some small changes. They've reverted it. I know some people had some issues with the overall keyboard and emoji picker before, but they've reverted it back for now. Another feature I didn't mention in iOS 18 that we found previously has to do with a different app, Voice Memos. If we go into our apps, then go down to Voice Memos where we have that, under Voice Memos here, we now have a new stereo recording option. I know many people have wanted this in previous versions. If you want stereo recording, there's now an option for it. So you can just enable it in Settings. I wish it was a little easier directly within Voice Memos, but it's not at this time. With Beta 3 re-release, if we go into the battery, there was a message with Beta 3 I really liked that actually told us, hey, I've just updated your phone, and that update is using additional power and may cause the phone to get a little bit warmer or increase the thermal temperature. If we go over the last 10 days, I don't see that listed anywhere today. If we scroll down, you'll see in today's battery usage, I don't see anything about that. But if we go back a few days, you can still see it there. So if we scroll down, you'll see device setup and updates. So maybe this will come back, but it looks like they may have removed it for now with Beta 3 re-release. Another thing they've updated today has to do with HomePod Mini. Now this is a bit of an odd re-release again, and it's actually introducing a HomePod Mini in midnight color instead of space black or space gray. So they've re-released it. They haven't really even changed the image itself. It's still the old image for many, and it's basically just a new color with a new name, but it's basically the same color. So if you have a space gray one, it's probably going to be the same. I'll see if I can compare them, but I have a white one here. I have a space gray or space black one at home. They're just re-releasing it with a new color. And if we go over to Apple Intelligence, that's still not active yet in iOS 18 Beta 3 re-release. Maybe they'll turn it on, maybe remotely with public beta one, but at this point, it doesn't look like it's active anywhere. Some people did send me some messages saying it sort of popped up randomly on its own, but they couldn't recreate it. So some people may be seeing parts of Apple Intelligence, but there's no new Siri yet either if we activate Siri. So we're still waiting for that. As far as bug fixes, well, there's definitely some bug fixes in this update. One of them has to do with customization. So if we go to Edit and then Customize, if maybe you have a dark background or you're trying to maybe customize it overall, you'll be able to easily switch and customize now. It seems like they've fixed that bug. They've also fixed the issue with the tinting bug. If it was really dark, it seems to have fixed those issues that people were having. You'll see as we switch back and forth, it's nice and fast, smoothly transitions, and it seems to be working well now compared to before where it was very glitchy, just sort of jumped around and wasn't working properly. So they've definitely fixed that. They've also fixed an issue with Spotlight. When we go into it, it seems to work properly now and bring up the keyboard every time. And there's still a few issues here, such as the wallpaper dimming bug. So if we do this, watch this area here for the color, just sort of desaturates or dims a little bit. It's been like this since earlier versions of iOS 17. I wish they'd fix it and just let us control that, maybe even control the vibrancy in the customization. When it comes to the release notes, well, there's not a whole lot to talk about other than what we had previously. So if we go into our feedback app, at the time of this video, they haven't updated the notes as far as that goes in feedback. But if we go to the public facing website, you can see here with the latest build number and go to the release notes, there's not a whole lot that's changed here. Basically the same release notes as before. There's about 150 things that they've actually resolved. Still some known issues, of course. They're still working on it. So if you are having bugs, be sure to check this out before you report them in feedback, as they may already be aware and working on it. But check through here, lots of different things that they've fixed with freeform, handwriting, health, many other issues all throughout. So a lot of different things. If we go all the way to the bottom, you'll see they've even fixed some things with cellular and T-Mobile. You'll see here T-Mobile users will not be able to initiate or receive Wi-Fi calls on secondary devices that are signed onto the same iCloud account. It's the same notes we had prior to this. As far as the overall update, well, the performance feels basically the same, not a whole lot to talk about there. And if we just scroll through things, whether that's ProMotion or anything else, things seem to be fairly smooth, less jumpy, but I have heard people complain about some keyboard lag already. That may be because they're still updating. And as far as overall heat of the device, well, it did get a little bit warm. I expect that. It's updating and installing things and indexing in the background. Makes a lot of sense. It's going to take some time for that. As far as benchmarks, well, so far, because I just installed this, they've been pretty poor. So it makes me think that maybe Geekbench needs an update to work with iOS 18, maybe a little bit more efficiently, or maybe it's just processing so much in the background that it's using that up and just not giving us great results. But I had 2,607 for single core, 5,173 for multi-core. If we go back to the history, you'll see it was definitely a little bit higher into previous versions. I ran it twice today, so I think it will increase over time. It seems like it's working in the background. As far as battery, well, I shared some of that a little bit earlier here, but if we go to battery health, I'm still at 95% with 246 cycles. So that's about normal, about 5% for every 250 cycles on an iPhone 15 series. That's in ideal situations. Now, as far as the overall battery life, it gets me through the day, but it's not great. And hopefully it is much better with the beta 3 re-release as they're getting it ready for the public. But I had 2 hours and 49 minutes of screen active time yesterday with 4 hours of screen idle time. The day before, 4 hours and 40 minutes and 3 hours and 1 minute of screen idle time, and used almost 100% of my battery. So it's not great. Definitely not as good as the public versions for me, but it seems like it's getting better throughout the betas at least. So that's good news. Now, as far as the public beta, I would expect that as soon as tomorrow. Basically, Apple has this every single time, the day before with the re-release, and then the day after that, they have the public beta. So based off of that, I would expect it Tuesday or Wednesday with a public beta release. Then you can try it out. So if you're wondering if you should install iOS 18 beta 3 re-release, if you're a developer, definitely install it. If you're a public beta tester, I would wait for that and then just make sure that you're signed up for it. So if you're wanting to try it out, I would do a backup of your device right now. Go to beta.apple.com. You can sign up for it now for all of the different versions. So sign up here. Then when you go to your software updates, it will show up there as one of the options. So if we go to our settings, then you go to general and then software update, you'll see it here as one of the beta options when it's available later, probably tomorrow or the next day. As far as iOS 17.6 RC, I could expect that as soon as tomorrow as well, although they could push that a day or two at this point. And then of course we're waiting for that public release. It looks like Apple has scrapped iOS 17.5.2 and they'll probably just wait for iOS 17.6, which should be out probably next Monday or Tuesday at this point. And then we'll have some bug fixes, security updates, and more. iOS 18 public release is typically in mid-September. So if you're waiting for that, it's going to be a couple months, usually around the iPhone 16 launch. So that's everything in iOS 18 beta 3 re-release and public beta 1. Let me know if you've found any other bug fixes or feature changes in this update. I'd love to hear from you in the comments. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.